welcome back. We had to have just a quick break then between people needing toiletries. I, for one, was one of those people.
And so was I.
Bladder control may be an issue, but it's all good. As you look up here, as we do come into the game though, we do see only, well, three in for RMG. Who have we lost? Scarecrow. Where's Scarecrow gone?
I'm not sure. He was talking on Skype, so I'm not sure whether he, you know, he backed out, he wimped out.
Unfortunately, that was a bit of a premature start for me. We jumped in. We were going to talk about the map again and the 26 points difference, which we're still going to talk about because with Strike Zone, 26 points is actually nothing.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, you know, all it takes is a constant hold of the A and C flag and spawn trap them in B, and that lead can quickly melt away.
You know, when you look, if you get a triple cap at any point, you know, those 3 seconds, then the positive 3 seconds, that's 6 points straight away. If you can head up to 15 to 20 seconds, that's 24 points. They're then only 2 points behind that 26. So it can be eaten up so fast. Guys, please tweet the stream out. If you haven't done so already, please do it. If you have done it, can you do it again? It would be very nice of you. It would be really, really nice. I would like to see also who you think is going to win. Put hashtag Gfinity to see who's going to take this one. It's currently 2-1 to Fiction. Rage Mode did take the SND. But as I said before, the guys from Fiction just seem to be better as a slaying team, and you know, these game modes such as Blitz and also Domination works in their favour, Rage.
Yeah, you know, it's a little bit peculiar because, you know, from what we've seen, RMG seems to be in favour of the S&D game mode, and you know, they took that quite comfortably, to be honest. And then Friction won the respawn game mode, so it's definitely interesting to see how it works. But you know, hopefully it's a fair game, and hopefully it goes into the fifth round, because that'd be interesting for myself, and for you, and for all the viewers.
Fifth round games are always epic to watch. If it does go to fifth, it will be SND, and I can give you the actual map that it will be. It will in fact be Sovereign. So it would be quite nice in a way. We started with Sovereign Domination. We could end with Search and Destroy. At the moment, Fiction do have that 26-point lead. Let's see if they can gain on that, or we're going to see RMG bring it back and push it to the fifth. It's going to be really, really interesting. Just to give an update as well on the next game that will be streamed live will be AE. If you don't know who AE are, they are Afflicted Esports. They have a nice lineup. I'm not going to go through that just yet because we won't know who's playing until we get into the lobby. And then we have Neo Esports. They have a nice lineup. There's only four of them. It's Epic, Seb, Nemesis, and Tron. I believe that's how you pronounce that. So that will be your next semi-final. That will then predict who will go on and face the winner of this. It's currently 2-1 to Fiction. iRage, your prediction here?
You know, I don't want to say this because I'm a big fan of Scarecrow, but I'm going to have to say that Friction are going to take this. I mean, they've got a comfortable lead of 26. I know we've said that it can easily wither away, but, you know, they're looking strong on these respawn game modes, and I believe they're going to carry up that form.
CJ, I have to be honest, all the way through, Fiction have been around the positive start. The only time they didn't was on the SND. They got some plays, but the guys from RMG, SND was most definitely their game mode. We'll look here again. We're going to run on with CJ. Yeah, they're all literally going to bump up on A. And the reason why they do this, because it is such a small map, it allows them to gain that point at much quicker, which they are straight away a point ahead off the bat against RMG. It's great plays here, but they are losing this. It doesn't matter because CJ comes in with a jump shot. He gets taken out on the right hand side. We're going to literally jump on the crutch. He's going to gain this one for the team of Fiction. They are doing ever so well here. It's A and B in their favour.
Yeah, although saying that, they are losing A, so by looks of things, Crux is, oh no, I'd expect him to run down to that C location. Yes, it looks like he's going to do that now. However, he's probably going to find some heavy resistance from the likes of the RMG crew, and especially RMG Skate crew, who's sitting
Guys,
on this bridge.
I want to tell you something very, very special right about now. The finalists and these guys that are playing, yeah, we have a little treat in store. So in the final, it's going to be really interesting, right? That they will be playing for Gfinity 3 spectator passes. So this isn't a is not a case of, you know, there's 8 elite teams in this, right? Okay, they've gone down to 4. This is a semi-final, so whoever gets through here will play in the final for the, and I tell you what, the event arena itself is immense. It is for final for the G3 tickets. Okay, it's not travel or anything that included. It's just the tickets themselves. But that is a great, great thing. That's what, nearly £100 in its own there for the tickets. So it's a big thing for these guys to go for, to be honest.
Yeah, you know, even if I knew, I probably would have just entered in a one-man team myself, and I probably would have won it easily because, you know, those tickets are to die for, and, you know. If I'd known, I would be in. I'd be in this tournament and probably not in the final.
Yeah, look at Muffin Man. I'm not even going to dispute that at all. And if we look at here, Muffin here, he's literally taking B by himself. He's going to gain this. This is the time they need a triple cap. They're bringing it back. They've gone 2 points up. They need a 2 point cap for at least 2 minutes, a minute and a half, I think my calculations are correct. And if you see him get tagged up there, it's the guys that need to do something. They're going to push for the C-Dom. They're going to push it and they're going to take it out. No, there's no neutralization. It's still a game. As we see plays from the Frost himself, he came in, took the kill. He's now going to go and push towards C. They need to get a neutralization here pretty fast.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, they really need to get this neutralization, and otherwise, he's going to lose vital points. Saying that, Crux does get a nice kill on that A flag, and he's going to be going for the capture now. Places that trophy to prevent any stuns. He actually sees second on A2 stairs. He gets a nice kill there, and that was extremely well played individually by him.
And again, he goes down by Carbon, which means Carbon's going to be on this C Dom. He's going to take this. Sorry, securing it. No, he doesn't. He goes down. Oh my word, Trap takes the kill. Trap goes down. Who is that on there? Is that Crux? No, it's not. They're going to gain this one back. Oh my word. They're taking C. They've managed to get it, but it's going to be... Oh, this is going to go down to the wire, I'm telling you now, because they're only 11 points in lead. Now down to 10. Then RMG need to do something and do it now if they want to bring this back. There's 26 points the deficit. Otherwise, we will see our first finalist going through, and it looks like it could be fiction.
Yeah, indeed. You know, they have an extremely dominating lead, gun skill. I wouldn't say lead because it's still extremely close, but they do have that 26 points backup cushion. And, you know, 1 minute left. RMG really has to go for a triple cap.
Yeah, remember, you get special. 3 points for a triple cap, so you work that. If you hold that for a minute, it's 36 points. That means they will be ahead by 10 points. Not only would have they eaten that deficit, they would have taken the lead. They are not going to do this. It's 65 points apiece. Even with a 2 point gap, even with a 2 point flag capture for a minute, it's only going to give them 10 points. 20, yeah, so only going to hold that. They're not going to have enough time to do it. It's 74 to 65 in the favour of Fiction. Fiction are your winners here in this semi-final, taking this 3-1. It was extremely well played by Fiction. They came in, they knew what they had to do. These guys have taken it. And I'll tell you what, they look a pretty strong team going into the final here. Just clean it up. It's just going to be formalities now. 3 seconds left. Well played to these guys. Both teams, both to RMG and also to Fiction, currently going through into the final. They're our first team. We will be live very soon with our second semi-final, which will be Afflicted Esports versus Neo Esports. We will be back right after this break. Do not go anywhere, guys. And again, I have to say, casting with me for this will be the one and only Ion. What's up, guys? Welcome back live to the other semi-final. This is going to be Afflicted versus Neo Esports. And I tell you what, you got any predictions here, Rage?
To be honest, I'm going to have to go for my favourite team. Well, not my favourite team, but my favourite player, RV Seb, so Neo. Although, saying that, looks like we're going to have to start it because a couple of the Afflicted boys have not got in.
Just want to make sure we get all the names all correct. If you have any queries, please let me know. So this is Neo. I myself am going to pretty much go, if it's going to go close, I think you could be looking at a possible 2-3. It's such a hard one to call. Any team that you look at there, it does come down to that, you know. It's going to be skills, it's going to have to be something big. I don't know Neo as a team, I've not seen them play, so I can't really, it's such a hard one for me to call, to be honest with you. Really, the team wise in the lineup, if you look, it's quite strong. Afflicted, I know, can be quite a strong team. Sebs is a good player. I'm going to say Afflicted could take this. If they do, it'd be 3-1, 3-2. I don't think it's going to be a straight 3-0.
Yeah, I agree. I don't know. Afflicted do look like a strong team. We have an extremely strong lineup. So, you know, it could go anyway, as you just said. So, you know, it's
guys,
interesting.
Don't forget, if possible, can you tweet this stream out? Let's get some viewers in here. These guys need your support. This is an esports community. As much as we can get out there, it'd be absolutely great. Remember also, if you want to sign up to any online events or any teams that want to do so, go to gfinity.net or follow them at gfinity. Also, any videos of any past games that gfinity have done on their live stream, if you check the VODs, it's gfinity TV. And you know, these guys host not just Call of Duty, they now do Dota, FIFA, they also have StarCraft. Big things going on at the moment, these guys. And also with the announcement of G3 at Copper Stadium at the Olympics Park there, it's going to be absolutely immense. And do you know what? The winner of this event will win 4 tickets to the G3. I am jealous.
So am I. I mean, you know, we should get a caster's team to going, and you know, we would obviously win it. I mean, I don't like to sound big-headed, but me, you, two more, and we'll get those tickets, and we'll be there. So, you know, you could enter these tournaments, and you'll probably see us there without tickets from winning.
Who knows what's going to go down on G3? All I know is that event looks so, so nice. Really have done an amazing job. Also, I'm pretty certain you're going to see a lot of the Gfinity admins there. These guys do an amazing work. So, as you see, Styles working overtime tonight. As we are live with this Gfinity 4v4 Esports Cup. And so far, Fiction go through. They take their game 3-1. I cannot wait, right, to be honest with you, to see how this is going to go down. I'm going to jump on with Focus 5s to see what these guys from Afflicted can do.
Yeah, indeed. You know, they've got a nice little reputation going. So it should be interesting to see how they go and see how they start off the bat.
Yeah, if we're looking at the plays here, we see all four from Afflicted running with MTARs. And these guys here, in fact, there's only one player running an R5, and that is Epic. Epic is running an R5. So we're going to jump back on with Focus 5s. He's going to go for a nade over the top. Going to clean on that right-hand side. Let's put on the Oracle mode, because you can see it. As Focus 5s goes down early on, Nemesis takes him out. And that means we're going to literally default onto Epic, who's looking at this B-dom because they are losing this play. It's currently 3.4. Early doors there for these guys, and he goes down on board with Nemesis, and he starts to clean up on his B-Dog. Takes two. Good play there. It's M-Boys and Cows that go down. We could see this switch right up, and they're going to gain the lead back here.
Yeah, indeed. You know, it was extremely, extremely hectic for the first 30 seconds of that game. A lot of kills and a lot of deaths. He's jumping ball with Nemesis now. He's actually playing it a little bit sneaky. He goes on the ground, that B-Dome, gets one kill. He's going to have to pop up and get two kills, but he gets taken out, though. He must have been called out.
He did there on ball with M-Boys. M-Boys comes in. He gets taken down as Seth goes down. We're now going to go on with Afflicted Seth. Seth here on the right-hand side. Teammate does a lot of work. His kills have got the jump and drop shot at the same time. They're currently holding A, B, and C. This triple cap could be lethal here.
Yeah, indeed. You know, they're going to have to get themselves out of this Neo-R, because otherwise it's going to be a little bit hectic. Nemesis goes huge with a two-piece on that C flag and actually gets the flag back. So nice play there by him.
They're going to try and push. They are losing A as we talk, though. In comes the shots fired. Tron goes down. A Kals takes the kill. It's a headshot as we see two kills there from a four Afflicted. There's the third. Nemesis goes down and Seth pushing forward on his left-hand side. As you can see with Oracle mode, we do see players. He's going to clean this one up. He does that very well. And he comes in for the second. There's possibility of a third coming to his left-hand side. Needs to be careful. He's right there. Oh, shots fired. Takes his fourth as he gets taken down, which means we're now going to run on with Focus. As he goes down, we're going to run on with M-Boys, who's on a 3.3 clean up here on the right-hand side.
Yeah, indeed, M-Boys have been playing extremely well now. And, you know, it should be interesting to see how it affects us. He actually just get taken down, though. So let's jump on board with Afflicted Seth now, who was the only member left. Yeah, exactly. I was a little bit confused there, as all of them got taken out apart from him. So he's going to have to make some moves around this B flag. He gets one kill up the control. He turns around, tries to get second. He doesn't see the guy contested it and gets taken out.
Which means we're going to run on now with Nemesis, currently 10 and 6. He is the only player to hit double figures for Neo Esports here, as he now takes his 11th kill with two captures. He's going to go for his 12th there, cleans that one up. There's literally another one right underneath him in Snake. He needs to be aware of this. He's going to see him because he's going to go and push for C neutralization. Who is that going for C? It is indeed. Look at this. It's M-Boys. M-Boys comes in, gets taken out, and this is where you're going to see these guys step this up. It has to be done now. A minute 50 left here for these guys from Afflicted.
Yeah, indeed. Afflicted have started extremely strong now. They have a formidable lead, and you know they're only going to try and advance on that. Although saying that, all of Afflicted are down, so now Neo are going to have to have an extremely, extremely good time to get that C and get that B, and hopefully get this lead back.
15 and 6. I'm just going to stand by with him, give him some love as he takes another kill, doing some great work. You see Seb and Epic take out Seth and Kals on your right hand side. They do seem to be bringing this back slowly but surely. They dropped it down to 8 points the difference. They, do you know what? With a minute left, they could take this round.
Yeah, you know, it'd be a great comeback to see. Nemesis is going huge individually. He's just checking around the side. He sees one more. Gets a nice kill there on Seth. And he's going to be locking down this blue snake area, making sure that no one attacks. Well, the same, they just get another kill. He's playing extremely well now, going huge for his team. And, you know, he's got 18 kills to his name. Made that 19 as he gets a nice kill on Focus 5.
Yeah, Nemesis is on a 12 streak. Locked into his specialist. This one is right. So he gets a kill. Yes, he does. Oh, my word. Surely he's going to go for the reload. He takes it. Oh, he goes down. And it's Kals that ends that streak. But Seb's on a streak of his own. He's currently 11 and 8. 6 point streak. They are going to take the lead. Surely 69 to 68 with 30 seconds to go. This is exactly where they want to be right now, which means they should go in holding these A and C. They should go in 5-6 points up, I believe. Working this at 7 points up. There's 71 and 75. There's your 4 point difference. Just waiting for the clock to tick over again. There's the 5 points. We're going to jump into 7 points. Surely they're going to bring this. There it is. There's a 6 points difference. These guys know exactly what they're doing. It's going to be 74 to 81. They've played an absolute blinder, had such a huge deficit. They brought it back and took it, and they've taken this round by 7 points. I did not see that coming from Nemesis.
Yeah, you know, it was an extremely well by this team, and you know, they've just come back when, to be honest, I counted them out, and I'm pretty sure you must have counted them out, and they've come back and proved us both
indeed.
Wrong.
And guys, if you have any, well, if you have any questions or any you want to require any answers on how Nemesis did that, tweet them, please, because they just out of nowhere stepped it up. Nemesis went on streak. He just absolutely annihilated these guys. They came in, 12 point streak. Then Seb went on a 6 point streak. They got the dominations down. They stuck to their guns. And wow, 7 points the difference. I cannot wait to see how they're going to pan this one out. They just seem to be so well together towards the last half of that.
Yeah, indeed. You know, that was a great show of teamwork and communication. What's a little bit surprising, because they are a newly formed team. Literally within the month, they're newly formed. So it's great to see that Neo is proving strong in the early steps. And, you know, that's only going to make them stronger in the future.
It is indeed, guys. If you join us live, this is our second semi-final. This is Neo Esports versus Afflicted Esports. Currently winning by 7 points on this domination. It is the first map of this semi-final, and I tell you what, if this is anything to go by, we're in for a freaking treat.
We are. I'm liking your PG use of the words there, and you are extremely right. It is going to be extremely exciting.
You're going to see on your top screen right about now. You will see the score change to 6. That will give you the point difference, right, from, so, was it 6 or 7? It was 7, wasn't it? It's 7 points, the difference. So you will see a 7. That means that these guys have a 7-point advantage. What the guys from Afflicted need to do is eat in quickly to that and then carry on and capitalise on taking those rounds. But as we run on with Sebs, and Sebs takes a kill, 3 down of Afflicted. Wow. Straight off the bat, great opportunity for these guys here from Neo to jump on B. Gets contested straight away on the right hand side. Oh my
and
word!
Ooh.
That just went down.
That was really surprising. M-Boys had a suppressed weapon, what is extremely unusual to see. I'm not sure whether that was a strategical play or he's got it on again. I'm not sure why he's using that, but you know, it worked well. He got 2 kills on that flag, but unfortunately his team couldn't capitalise on that.
Yeah, they did indeed. What happened there? They got split too much. It was pushed on and the 3 went down straight away. Afflicted came back, were just too weak to take it. They're going to go for neutralisation of A, but we do see Tron, I believe his name is, come in, take that twin. I have no idea how to pronounce that. If someone can tell me in English, that would be great. So anyway, as we do run on board with him, he's currently 4-0 on a 6-point streak. He has 2 captures, 4 kills. There's his 5th kill. There's his 6th. Oh, no! He ends that, and it does seem that these guys seem to be slightly slowing down. Afflicted Cal's now pushing 2-2. He's on a 3-point streak, and this is what Afflicted need to do. They need to hold and take control of B and C.
Yeah, indeed. You know, I believe we let's just try and pronounce it Twin. No, I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, let's just forget about it. Let's just say the guy who is going off right now, saying that he actually gets shot in the back. So it's a little bit unfortunate. Jump on board with Nemesis, who we can actually pronounce as he jumps around that B bomb. Gets a nice kill up top. He's going to be on that B. Tries to get the pre-fire around the corner, but doesn't get it. And by the looks of things, he's going to secure it. He's going to be a little bit contested from his left. He gets picked off by his teammate, who we can't pronounce. But you know, it's a great play there by the team.
Nemesis was very lucky. If he had actually taken shots, only 2 bullets would have come out there. Had to go for the reload. Doesn't manage to take it. His teammate cleans that one up. And again, they're holding B and A ever so well. And you know, the same strategy with these guys. They seem to be playing the scenario. If they go pushing, we take another kill for Nemesis. If they lose one dom, they just need to push on to the next. Go for a contest. There's a jump shot again. And Nemesis again going off. Gets taken out though, and it's Kowser comes in and is going to clean it up himself. He gets taken down, and it is, in fact, I believe it was Tron that takes the kill again as he goes down. So it means we're going to run on with Seb. Seb throwing up smoke, seeing if he can hit anyone up. They are losing B. There's one on the left hand side as Seb goes down. Who is that man on there? Is it Afflicted? Oh, Kowser takes the kills. M-Boys pushing forward and then gain back B. Look at this.
I believe, according to the chart, it is pronounced Truen. So that's how the actual guy himself said it, because he actually typed in chat. What's a little bit worrying, considering he's supposed to be playing the game for some G-Finity tickets, but you know, that's the way he plays. Clearly it's doing well. He's got 10 kills to his name, and you know, his team do actually are playing extremely well.
Nemesis, though. Nemesis currently 7-8, and it's Chuen who's currently again 11-6, and we are on board with him. He's looking for a place to kill on his left hand side. It's 50-47 in the favour of these guys. 3 points of difference, 1:20 on the clock. It's plenty of time for them to bring it back. Are they going to gain B back? Need to be careful. The Warbands, one comes behind him, takes a double kill. It is indeed Focus Fives. Five's coming alive now. He needed to do that. You know, this is the time that they need to bring it back. Looking at the score, it's 51-53. 3 points of difference still, as they're now losing C. They're going for C now, right? They need 7 points to draw this. This is going to be hard.
Yeah, you know, it's going to be extremely close. For the last 50 seconds now, it is going to be tense. Both the scores are tight. And, you know, I believe it was only a 6 point lead or seven?
Yeah.
It's going to be close. It's going to be extremely close.
This, two, four, six. It's totally possible to be done. It can be done here. Oh my word, look at Afflicted here. It's 62-64. They've got a 2 point gap. They need another. Oh my word, 65-64. There's only a point difference. Oh my god, it's 66. All fives needs to get this now. It doesn't matter because they're losing me. Oh my word. There's the kills. It's going to go down. It's 68. They cannot do it. This means that Neo will take the first round on Sovereign. Neo Esports will be your first round winners here, taking this 1-0 in this best of five series. Wow, they really did bring that to the wire. Well played to Afflicted. That was such a close game. They're managing to bring it back. Just didn't have the anger or the aggressiveness to take it any further than that. But look at those kills. That just says it all. Such an even play. And top fragger for me, I have to say, throughout that was, in fact, Nemesis. Guys, do not go anywhere. We will be back after this short break with your SND. Welcome back. We are SND. It's all about the freight, and I tell you, this map is, and we saw this in the first semi-final, where it was 6-1 to the guys from RMG, managing to bring that round back. Is this a round for Afflicted? Are they SND bad boys, or are we going to see the team of Neo Esports progress 2-0? This map is crazy for SND. I love this. It can be so quiet, then all of a sudden it just goes off.
Yeah, you know, I mean, it should be interesting. It's one of those maps. And, you know, I'm going to have to jump on board with... I'm going to say that Neo are going to win. But let's jump on, boys, with M-Boys, who is running a very, very aggressive route straight through the middle of the map. Hopefully going to try and get some picks. Smokes are going down. He actually doesn't get seen to his left. We bang on that Oracle mode. We can see whereabouts players are. Nemesis gets one kill. Does he get the second? He actually gets taken out by Cows. And by the looks of things, other setup, it looks like it's going to be a big push.
He's immediately jumping up top. It's okay. He does get seen. Surely, as you see, with the Oracle mode on, he's going to push forward. He's going to go top here. Seeing literally two to his right hand side. They do have this covered. It looks like they've got these guys pinned in here. You see Seth down there on the bottom right hand. Cows is pushing forward on the right. There's one literally coming up right behind him. Cows could get taken out at any moment, but he's managed to evade him. Oh my word, what's going to go down? Is it Seth? Seth goes down. Look at him, boys. Does he? Shots fired. Tagged him up, but doesn't get the kill. He goes down. It's all down to Cows. He goes down. It's a pretty easy straight win. Nemesis is the only guy being taken out for Neo. Sebs is going to get the defuse there. Literally, shots fired. A bit of showboating, I would say. But, you know, they're doing really well here. Well played to these guys. Now 1-0 up in this SND. And it's going to be down to them on the attacking. So we're going to literally run on with Seb straight from the bat. Was that what you expected? You know, was it too fast for Afflicted? Did they lack the aggression? Or was it just a really good setup defensive-wise by Neo?
You know, I'm a little bit flabbergasted, to say the word. Because, you know, Effect did use a very unique route straight off the bat, going straight to B, and, you know, it managed to hurt them. They're actually doing more with Seb now, who's got two kills to his name, and now he's got that plan for his team, and that's going to be vital for him and his team.
Though, as soon as they plant the bomb, they are backed right up. They're going to now let them come to him. As we see, a nade from Sebs takes out M-Boys, which means it is Sebs, Truen versus Cows, Seth, and Focus Fives. He's looking on his right inside. He knows someone is there. There's someone's going for the defuse. He gets taken down, which means it's Truen. It's the only guy that's left. He's not going to get it. They're going to get the defuse. I believe it's the man. Afflicted Cows is going to take that. One round apiece. Great start. Afflicted really making up for the first round error.
Yeah, indeed. You know, they've really... They've really sorted themselves out. They didn't have the strongest first round, but, you know, they've come back fighting, and now the second round is extremely strong.
Which means we're going to jump on here with the guys from Afflicted. Let's run on with Seth. Seth, the bomb carrier, pushing through on the left-hand side. Cows, obviously, with the bomb plant from the previous round on B. There's a play, literally pushing on this left-hand side. Shots fired, he's having a look. Someone's going to call that out. Surely they must know he's there. Mid-tracks, shots going down. He's looking, Seth's looking, he sees the bullets flying, he knows he's there. He's just taking his time. Seth is the only person who's now left. He picks up a kill, so it's 2-on-1. Let's run on with Sebs. He's going to flash that one up. No one's there. He's just going to hold out and wait. Epic's pushing, he knows he's there as well. Come on, man, let's run on with Seth. Seth on his own. This is a... Justin, mate, do you know if he'd been about a second quicker, he would have had that. He would have taken it all the way through. Well played there by Type Epic. Just literally picked him off. Gives it a little knife in the air just to say, yeah, I got you. I know. Right, so which means we...
Yeah, indeed. A little bit of showboating there, but, you know, it's expected. I do all the time. Not that I get much kills, so, you know, it's once in a rare.
Once every 56 kills does he showboat. It's a rarity there. As we see RV Seb pushing forward. He's now going to go on his right side. Shots fired though. Gets tagged up very quickly here. Nemesis gets taken out. A long range shot. Epic. He's been tagged up. Truen. He's just nice and clean. But Seb's managed to regain his health here. They are really in between a rock and a hard place, to be honest with you. He's trying to look for his right hand side. He's managed to get to bottom three story red. There's a whole team in there and he knows it as well. As Epic goes down, Truen and Seb's are on their own. Let's see what Turin can do from back here. Sebs goes down.
Yeah, you know, it's going to be interesting now. It is Trin. I forgot how he pronounced it already. In a 4v1 situation, he gets a nice kill there by M-Boys to close it down. 2-2.
Yeah, play there. Two round apiece. Each team effectively winning their defensive round. So it's until you're going to get someone that can break that, it's going to go all the way and it will be the advantage to Neo Esports if they manage to carry on this streak. We're going to jump on with Afflicted here. Are we going to see something different here? I'm pretty certain we could actually see a B push if Seth is going to continue to go on this left-hand side.
Yeah, you know, I've said it before, when I've played four teams and also coached for teams, defense wins rounds, and both teams are showing a great display of this, and it's really going to be interesting to see how it plays, because, you know, the teams have to win the attack rounds now, because
yeah,
otherwise not.
You need to break these, you need to take your attacking round, you need to break them defensively. As soon as you do that, that is advantage your team. As we do see two go down, it's down to Type Epic versus Druid. Truin there gets taken down, and Seth's going to go for the reload. Truin just needed to jump down out of the way, but there's one on his right hand side. Shots fired. Does he see him? He gets down. Down to Epic. This is what Afflicted need here. They need this attacking round.
Yeah, they do, but you know,
there's
it's going to be interesting. Oh. The bomb does go down. Focus 5
That's
gets
That's exactly what happens if you poke your head out of there of top three. Because as soon as you get that and someone's going for bomb plant, unless you've got a setup like this, then you are going to get your head taken off. Well played to Afflicted. They managed to take that attacking round. First team to do so. 3-2 advantage in their call. It's going to be down to Neo on their turn to see if they can do the damage. Who do you want to go on board with?
Let's jump on board with Seb. You know, he's a great guy. I've spoken to him a lot, and he has that bombs, and also he has a overkill sniper. I'm not sure. Ooh, that's embarrassing. So let's just forget that never happened, and let's jump
again
on board. Yeah, let's jump on board with Steph, who's got that thermal around the right hand side. He gets a few shots, doesn't get any kills though. I know he's being pressured, and now Trin picks him up.
Epic though. This is the attacking team. He's cooking. Does he get anything from that? Nothing at all. Cooks his second. Tries to go for an alley-oop. He's not going to go in there. It's currently 3-3. Oh, and this is going to be so close. They need to break this. They've got to get the bomb. Someone has to get that bomb. Who is going to pick that bomb up? This is no point getting the kills. Because if you don't get a bomb down on the second team, does he? Shots fired. Tags him up, but he doesn't get the kill.
To be honest, I wouldn't want to pick up that bomb because a lot of people have died up there and it is in a little bit of a scary location.
Is he going to get the turn on him? Yes, he does. And Epic cleans up him. Trin gets taken down by Cows. It's 2-1 now. If they get the kill, though, it's a huge advantage to them. Look at M-Boy's mid-tracks. He just knows he's got to wait it out. No one's going to get the bomb down.
Yeah,
shots
indeed,
fired.
And that is exactly
he goes
what it's
down.
Be doing.
4-2. Well played, M-Boys. Just done enough to take that round. Afflicted now 4-2 up.
Yeah, you know, Afflicted have come on strong, playing extremely, extremely well. And, you know, it's great to see such a balanced game, in fairness. I mean, Neo won the first round, and now Afflicted have won the second, by the looks of things. Although, saying that, Neo could easily come back and win.
Yeah, M-Boy's coming on a 3-streak, which means he is now off that donut. He was running the same score as Styles for a very short while there. And Styles isn't even playing. So look at M-Boy's here. He's currently 3-3, taking those kills, bringing that round back for these guys. 4-2. And this is something they need to do again. If they take this attacking round, that is it really for these guys, because they just played so well throughout this. It's a great position to play, as I do say that. 2 go down from Afflicted. So it's a 4-2 advantage. Neo Esports here. It's so
yeah,
tense,
indeed,
it?
You know, it should be. It is. I know, just look at the positioning on the map. We see M-Boy's the last person left in a 4-1 situation. He sees one getting a nice kill there by himself. He's going to have to go huge. He knows that he needs to pick up this bomb and
yeah,
do something with it.
Yeah, as he goes down, they're winning around back. They've closed that little gap. It's now 4-3. And if it's going to be these guys, just look at here. Nemesis will be your kill cam. Just cleaning that up. M-Boy's had nothing else he could do there. So now Neo Sports just close that gap a little bit more. If they can bring this round back, make it on as even, but it's not going to be down to them. It's going to be down to the whether Afflicted can take the defensive play, as they have done in every round so far.
Yeah, you know, their defense has been extremely strong, and that is why they are currently in the lead, because of such a strong defense. That should be interesting.
Look at Sam pushing forward. He gets a bomb down, and all four are still alive. He's going to literally drop on this bottom tracks. I need to be careful. He's trying to push out as he sees one. Oh, shots fired, gets hit up. Oh my word, an invoice takes out Seb's. Great aiming. But his teammate's going to sit this one up. Long range shots. He takes it through the wall. Invoice goes down. It is currently 2-3. Nemesis and Epic have all the work to do. They're going to go for the defuse surely here. Who is that? Is that Fives? Fives is going for it. Fives. He's going to go five. Down. Oh, he gets a defuse. It's five. Oh. 5-3 even. Oh my word.
Seth just won. Seth just won that for his team. Seth, Focus 5 is getting shot, and Seth dived in front of the bullets like a bodyguard and
man,
took the kill.
Man, that was awesome play. Seth taking one for the team. And do you know what? It's not always about kills. It's distraction. And if you can do that for long enough, you're going to see a defuse. 5-3 here. I do actually see Afflicted Esports taking this now. They've been so strong. They've really turned on the SMD skills. You see Fives just wall banging through on the right hand side. Let's run on with Seth. It's company 7-6. He's played extremely well here on the SMD.
Yeah, he has. You know, it's extremely well to see. Such a solid score for his team. Although, interestingly enough, if we jump on board with Trin, who's actually sitting in this underground location, they know he's here, they're actually watching this, although he's opened the door once, and now he's going to open it again just to mess around with their minds, and now he's running back.
Yes,
cheeky
I just jumped
player.
On board as he opened that, I saw the arrow come back, and Seth's just like, yeah, okay, who's that? It's like playing Knockdown Ginger, but COD style. Well, she's going to open it up, we're going to have a look, and you're going to come and have a look, and I'm going to shoot you. Seth takes the kill. Trin didn't see him. He takes the plate. It's now down to Nemesis. He has so much work to do. There's 24 seconds left, and it's 2-1. Nemesis can do this. He just has a very little time to do it in. The bomb's going to go down. As soon as that bomb goes down.
The work is
oh, there's one.
Out
the bomb's
him.
Gone down, so he knows it's there.
He knows the second is.
This.
I'm not sure whether he's seen Kyle's there. I'm not sure whether he's seen Kyle's run away. Kyle's just going to play a little defensive. He knows he's probably going to run through this doorway, so he's just watching that. And by the looks of things, if you look at Oracle mode, it looks like all of them miss each other.
I tell you what, that worked in the favour of Neo. As soon as they took that bomb down, okay, right, they had that, right? But it had no option, otherwise, Neo would have won that round anyway, okay? But as soon as they put that bomb down, bang, he picked off one. He played it so smooth. Cows didn't see him come around from the corner. It's 5-4. Neo are still in this.
Yes, indeed they are. And, you know, it's a great comeback. I believe they've come back now for 2 rounds now. They've won. So, you know, they have the momentum going into this next round, and it should be interesting to see whether they can get another win and tie up at 5-5.
Yeah, going for the dual band R5, long range fire. Let's put on that Oracle mode so you can see what is going down as well. Literally on that right side, you see one pushing forward.
Oh, look at Seb. Seb and I'm not sure who this is. Yes, it is Epic. They're both on the ground. You don't realise that actually.
Oh my word, Epic takes the
battle. Oh, that was well played there.
Does take the battle, which means Cows goes down. And we're going to see M Boys go down. It's two left. Seb's in a prime position. He's going to go for the plant. This is great place here. We're going to see Epic go down. He's going to call that out. Surely they're going to have this round. Oh my word. We do see some issues here. What's going down? True in there, pushing forward. Nemesis currently 5. He's 11-6 on a 5 kill streak. Seb on a 1 point streak here. Oh, there's a shots are going down. Who's going to win that battle? Who is it? Oh, Trin goes down. So it's down to Nemesis and Seb. It's 2-2. And Seb is in a prime place. We could see a kill any moment here. One. There's one. There's two. Goes down. It's 5 apiece. Oh, my word. If you're not on the edge of the seat, should be. Neo, bring that. Can they win a third round on the bounce? Momentum is certainly in their favour here on Freight SND. Wow, Rage. I tell you what, this is pants wetting stuff.
You know, this is extremely, extremely exciting to spectate. And, you know, it is interesting to see how it goes. Neo does have the momentum, although Afflicted have shown throughout that they are the dominant force.
On the attacking round here. And I have to say, though, twice on the attacking round, Afflicted have struggled. Okay, so each round they've taken, it's always been in the favour of the guys from, apart from one round, sorry, of the favour of Neo. We do see Seth go down off that. He is the first down for Afflicted, and it's Epic that takes the kill, but it's Vimes that's going to go for the bomb plant. Is anybody going to see him? Sebs is sitting bottom three story. Nemesis is pushing forward, sees long range shot. Bomb goes down, and it's now down to these guys for the defuse.
Yeah, Cows and Emboys, the only two left for Afflicted against the full team of Neo. Afflicted Cows now is the only man left as Emboys gets taken out. He's going to have to go huge in this 4v1 situation. He waits for one to run past. Can you see the bomb? He's not going to shoot.
He's not going to shoot? He gets the defuse. It's game over. It's two.
What?
I'm not even going to question that. I don't know why he didn't. Remember, we can see, right, with the Oracle mode, they can't. It's now 6-5, which means that these guys from Neo are now 2-0 up. It's something I actually didn't think was going to go down. I have to be totally honest, I thought Afflicted could have been this. But we are going to be back with Blitz. Are these guys from Neo Esports going to take this 3-0? It's a joy to watch. Make sure you tweet this out. Let's get everybody in here, including their mothers, grandmothers, daughters, aunties and uncles. And we will be back after this short break. This is the third of the best of five. Neo currently 2-0 up. And it's an unexpected lead here, to be honest with you. I thought Afflicted might have taken it, but Neo just seemed so strong, man. You know, Afflicted possibly could have taken it round back if they'd taken the bomb diffuser out. Didn't it? It was Cows. I don't know whether we'd call it a choke or not. But joining me is the one and only iRage. Now, mate, you must be shocked by this as well.
Yeah, totally. I am completely confused and shocked. Neo did extremely well to come back, and now they must have the momentum. So let's jump on board with them, and let's jump on board with Seb, the captain of Neo, as he rushes down this left side now. Gets a little bit of a team kill, I believe, but nevertheless, he does get the kill. And, you know, it's a great start from Neo, with three kills to their name, and Afflicted have got none.
He's going to miss two people. Ooh. He's going to slide this one out. No one's going to see him. It's 1-0. How they didn't see him is beyond me. Defensive-wise, they just didn't check it. Great play from Seb. He's currently 2-0-1. Great start. And there's his third kill. He's running big down here on the right-hand side. He's going to niche. He's going to have to have a look. He doesn't get seen. He does get tagged up, though. Does manage to get tagged up, but he does get taken out, and it's Envoys that gets that kill, which means we are going to run on with Nemesis, currently 2-1 himself, and still yet to get a portal capture. These guys from Afflicted, I tell you, the last thing they need to do is sit back here, Afflicted. They need to push the guys from Neo into a spawn trap.
Yep, the best defense is a good offense, as the saying goes. And, you know, it's definitely comes true when it comes to a blitz play. Focus 5 now, having to make a little bit of pressure, running through that Genius area. He actually stops to get the kill. Hopefully, he does get the kill. That's a great play by him, picking up Seb, and now he's going to be making advances towards
their blitz portal. It doesn't matter, because Nemesis has slid another one home. He took a kill, Right, slid right through. We do see Focus Wives gain that one back, but that's not really going to matter to these guys. He's going to go for defensive player. Seth Nemesis again cleans up. And who is pushing forward? Who's the most man forward? In fact, I believe it could be M-Boys here. Yes, it is. Look at the take positional play here. Seth pushing through. Focus Fives again in the American bar. He's going to try and come around from the back here. And if they're not careful here, Neo can get put back into the spawn. That's the last place you want to see. A kill with the Focus. Goes for a second. Goes for his third. He gets taken down. And it's Epic. He's going to clean up here for Neo Esports. Let's jump on with Nemesis as he's defended extremely well for Team Neo Esports. He gets taken down.
Yeah, indeed. He did actually get taken out. So let's jump on board with Epic, who, you know, is making some advances. He hasn't got a cap to his name, although he's looking to rectify that. Makes some huge plays on this left side, getting a kill on Seth. But I just think he's going to duel back to his teammate. Gets a goal. No, he didn't get the kill. Nemesis got the kill. I was a bit shocked if he did get that kill. He does see a guy there and gets taken out as he leaves this tin building.
Seth coming in for 3-6. He's just pushing forward. He's going to pick up a kill on the right hand side there. Long range shot with that MTAR. MTAR again, one of the most favoured guns along with the R5, just purely for its stability and range that you can get. It is a short to medium range gun, you know, as well as the assault rifle does have that long range and medium effect. That's the big difference. It's just purely for its durability as a SMG. Now, true in there, it's coming 3-5. He's going to nade over the top. Going to sit this quite comfortably. Not going to push too much. Currently do have the advantage by the way of one capture. Both captures from, well, one from Nemesis and one from Severson. He's literally cleaning up here. This train's trying to turn middle map. He gets taken down as Cows gets the kill, which means we are going to run on with M-Boys, who's defending well with the Vector here for his team.
Yeah, you know, he's playing extremely well. Not that you actually know the name of this gun now, so, you know, it's great to see that you're remembering things. As I'm saying that, he is playing a solid defense around this burnout car. He actually doesn't see him. That's the curse of the Oracle mode. He does seem to be just be lying down around this portal area. He's not too confident about his defense. And now, I'm not sure what he's doing. He's just hovering around his portal. I think he's trying to go for the kill, but he doesn't want to drift too far away. What is he doing? He is yo-yoing back and forth.
As we do see, Turin coming. Oh my word, we're going to see another portal capture. It's 3-2, it's trade for trade there. It's Nemesis 2, Seb with 1. Focus 5 comes in, gets his second kill. Does get taken out as he did that though. But that does still give these guys from Neo Sports a lead with 40 seconds to go. They've just increased that. Seb's with 2, Neo now with 2. Epic here on this right hand side, cleaning up, gets tagged up and taken down. Let's run on with Nemesis, 13-7. This guy's having another great game.
Yeah, I agree with you there. He's got one more kill to his name, making it 14 kills. I'm giving him a 2 KD, gets a 15th, and now he's just going to make huge. He gets taken out to his left by Steph, so it's a little bit unfortunate by him. So let's jump on board with Epic. He hasn't had much of the limelight. It looks like they're just defending now. They're feeling pretty confident, and they're trying to try and bank this 2-point
exactly
lead.
What they need to do here. 4 seconds left. There's no point in pushing forward. They're only going to get put in the trap. Sit on that ball, pick up the kills, and they're going to go in 2 points the lead. And that, you know, it's important when you sit there and you watch gameplays like this, because it tactically just shows you that Neo know what they're doing. You know, they've gone for the trade for trade. They've always been a point to 2 points ahead. Nothing's gone any further than that. Now, in this second half, it's a totally different kettle of fish, right, guys? Normally, within 2 to 3 minutes, that's when it goes down. Here, this could go, slaying-wise, this could go into the hands, right, of Neo. Currently, 16-9 is Nemesis. 16-10 for 7. And very objectively, 10-8 here for Epic and Truin. Currently 7-8. It's looking worse for Afflicted because M-Boys is 6-11, 8-13. It's 11-5 for Cows. Cows is having a good game. It's just not being objectively played. You know what I mean? Again, you do see him go down as Focus 5 gets a kill. Fives is the big objective player for Afflicted.
Yeah, you know, he's going to have to make some moves around this point now. He has one kill to his name. He has to get shot around the post office area and gets taken out. There's someone on board with Nemesis, who clearly smells that his team has a good chance of winning these 4 tickets to G3. And now he's playing a little bit confident, getting one more kill to his name. 18 kills with only 10 deaths, 2 captures, a little bit of lag there for me. And, you know, he's pushing around this mid-map area and hopefully gets a kill. Yes, and there we go, bottom Gina's. Nice kill by him. Going to be pushing towards this point now. switching up a little bit, goes to the right rather than go through Genius. That's a great smart play by him, trying to confuse the defenders.
To two players though from Afflicted Esports, just waiting out patience. One to his left hand side, he goes down. Kowser's a little bit faster on that trigger. Let's have a look here. Oh, plays from Seb. He ducked down. He's going to be a little bit sneaky, right? But he saw him. He backed up. He saw another player on his right hand side. He's got to be really careful, otherwise he will get tagged up big time here. His teammate's going to see the players. He's going to take the kills out himself. He gets through. He does get tagged up. And if he makes this, no one is around to stop him. That's 5-3. Trade for trade again. 3 for Sebs, 2 for Nemesis, and 3 for Fives. Fives, I'll tell you what, you need Afflicted here. You need more than one person to push for this portal. It cannot be down to one person. And if you're not getting the luck there from Afflicted, let's see if Seth and M-Boys can do any better. Now, guys, just to reiterate, they are currently under 3 minutes away here, Neo, from going to the final to play for 4 tickets to G3. So there is a prize on the line here. Currently Afflicted 14-8. He's going to clear it defensive wise. He's going to bring that one home. Oh, it's 5-4. There's a point difference. And I said to you, 2 to 3 minutes left. What you're going to see, it's going to be a point first, and it's 5-5.
Yeah, you know, it is extremely close. Two and a half minutes left now. And as we say that, it looks like Neo have scored. So let's jump on board with Seb, who's going to have to try and capitalise on this point lead and hopefully make it 2, maybe 3 points.
Takes a defending kill. I had to jump on board with him purely because Afflicted was running focus fires forward. He literally got to the edge of that portal and Nemesis just went, "No, sir, you are being blocked." Took him out, and that just saved the skin. They need to bring this point difference back here with a minute 55 left in it. They need to do this. Otherwise, I'll tell you, Neo will win this 3-0.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, it's definitely interesting to see how Neo have all of a sudden turned up. He played extremely well in the domination and in the search, or out of nowhere, to be honest. It was behind. To be honest, everyone counted them out of losing the S&D, and they come back. And now it looks like they have the momentum. They want those tickets, and they want to see G3 at, to be honest, London's biggest land.
This is going to be one of the UK's biggest events, as there will be more than just Call of Duty there. But look at this. The spawns fell in the flag and fell in the favour of Neo. All 4 spawned on the defensive play, but he's going to see a portal capture. Oh, we know he gets denied and just stayed on him long enough so you can see it. But Kells is trying to put hand side. It's 7-6 to get trade for trade. Oh, my word, it's going down here. Oh, my word. They were even Stevens. It's now 7-6. It's 5 from Sebs. Sebs, son, where did you put that? That is a high five for you in the face with a chair.
I'm not sure if I would want a high five in the face with a chair to quote you exactly, but you know, he actually jumped on board with Seb. He's going to get a poor cut by the looks of things, making it 8-6 in favour to his team. He's going to have to go straight onto the defence, get a nice defence there, and by the looks of things,
yeah,
he's going to be pushing straight forward.
Drop back, and that's extremely important there because they do have point lead difference. It has been now dropped down to 1. It's 24 seconds left on the clock, and Seb's going to push through on the right hand side. He needs to continue to do this. If he does this, it's GG. It's surely going to be. As soon as they get that 3-point advantage, boom, there's your 2 points. Game over. Neo win this 3-0. They came, they saw, and they conquered. Well played to Neo. They will be in the final against Fiction Gaming.
Friction.
Wow.
Friction.
I tell you what, that is some sort of final. Just to give you a rundown, guys, on what the maps are going to be here. In this final, it's going to be best of five, Strike Zone Domination, we're going to hit that up with. Then it's Search and Destroy Warhawk, then Blitz Freight. If need be, we're going to hit Domination on Octane, Search and Destroy on Sovereign. So your final lineup will indeed be Neo Esports versus Fiction Gaming. If you have any predictions, guys, please tweet them out, you know, or put in the chat. 1 for Fiction, 2 for Neo. I tell you, Fiction need to bring something special here because these guys are bringing everything to the table here from Neo. I think Nemesis heard there was 4 tickets to G3 and was like, I'm going to take that.
Yeah, I mean, I was looking on the chat for the stream. Everyone should go there, be active. But I believe Seb just said that I think it was during the S&D game he said, oh, we finally realised that there's a prize. And then all of a sudden, they played extremely well. So clearly they must have went into the game thinking, you know, it's just a little bit of practice. Heard there was 4 tickets to G3 and turned up and, well, you know, we've just seen them play amazing.
That's it. And Lepic, you are exactly right. I did say 3-0, but I did say to the opposing team, you know, I'm glad to get it wrong. It just shows you that esports is very much alive in the community, and there are teams out there that are going to put down the bullets and lay it low. Now, guys, Rage will not, unfortunately, be joining me for the final. We will be having another cast. Please make sure you follow this guy on Twitter. His Twitter is _iRage. Thank you ever so much for joining me for the semi-finals. I'm really glad you had a good time. And we have more in the pipeline for you, sir.
Yeah, I hope so. I hope so indeed. Thanks a lot for having me. I really appreciate it. And, you know, the next caster is extremely well. I believe it is Slinky. And, you know, he has a great experience. And, you know, all the best to him and you for tonight. And good luck to two teams.
Guys,
thanks
please
for
do
me.
Not go anywhere. We will be back after this short break. With your finals, it's Fiction versus Neo. It's gonna go down. We'll see you shortly.